Last time we started to look at power series. So let's suppose that you've got a power series, a sum as n goes from 0 to infinity of some coefficient times x to the n. And we learned that this converges whenever x is smaller than the radius of convergence, and it diverges whenever x is bigger than the radius of convergence, and when the magnitude of x is equal to the radius of convergence, that is, when x is r or minus r, then it's tricky. But we thought of this as a problem for one x at a time. You tell me what x is, and I'll tell you whether this thing converges. Now we want to think of this as a function. We want to see how this expression depends on x. So in particular, what sort of functions is it going to be like? And can all functions be written in this way? Well, no. There are a bunch of functions that cannot be written in this way, and we'll see that some can't be written in this way because they're not differentiable, and then others can't be written in this way because for more subtle reasons, but not every function can be written this way. However, almost all interesting functions can be written in this way. All of the standard functions that you run into in calculus, sines, cosines, various trig functions, inverse trig functions, exponentials, logs, powers, rational functions, they all can be written as power series. And we can get lots of mileage from doing that. And finally, we can ask about how do you do calculus with power series? Well, if you look at just a few terms in the power series, what you've got is a polynomial. Do you know how to take a derivative of a polynomial? Sure, it's pretty easy. Can you take the integral of a polynomial? Also easy. So by representing functions as sort of like polynomials, but the terms keep going and going and going, we make taking derivatives and integrals very, very easy. We'll get the theorem about these derivatives and integrals shortly in the next video. But in this video, I want to work out some examples of some functions that can be expressed as power series. So we know that the geometric series 1 plus r plus r squared plus r cubed and so on converges to 1 over 1 minus r as long as the magnitude of r is less than 1. Now, you might be tempted to put r equals x, and that'll work. But in fact, this works for r equals anything. No matter what quantity we're looking at, for any quantity that's less than 1, you can write 1 over 1 minus that as 1 plus the quantity squared plus the quantity cubed, and so on. In particular, we could do it for x. And there we go. We've got a function that we're used to thinking about. We know how to graph this function. We know how to take the derivative of this function. We know how to take the integral of this function. And we can write it as a power series because it's just a geometric series. We could do the same thing for 1 over 1 plus x, because 1 plus x is just 1 minus minus x. So in this case, a is minus x. So we get 1 plus minus x, sorry, plus minus x squared, which is x squared, plus minus x cubed, which is minus x cubed, plus minus x to the fourth, and so on. We could do it for x squared instead of for x. It's the same formula, it's the same geometric series, as long as x squared is less than 1, which is to say, as long as x is less than 1, then the series is going to converge. So we've got a series for 1 over 1 plus x squared. So now we're starting to rack up a decent number of functions that we can take, that we can apply power series to. You can also deal with things where the denominator is not 1. If you're interested in 1 over 5 plus x, you just factor out the 5. That's 1 fifth of 1 over 1 plus x over 5. And that becomes, the 1 fifth comes along for the ride, and 1 over 1 plus stuff is 1 plus minus stuff squared minus stuff cubed plus stuff to the fourth. And it works whenever the stuff is less than 1. In this case, the stuff is x over 5, so this works whenever x in magnitude is less than 5. So there is an explicit power series. There's the formula for each term for the function 1 over 5 plus x. Finally, you can deal with things where there's a numerator. How do you deal with x squared over 1 plus x? Well, you just take 1 over 1 plus x, this is 1 over 1 plus x, and you multiply it by x squared. So x squared times 1 is x squared, x squared times x is x cubed, x squared times x squared is x to the fourth, and so on. We could also have gotten the same result by long division. We could have said x squared divided by 1 plus x is x minus 1 with a remainder of 1. In other words, x squared over 1 minus x is x minus 1 plus 1 over 1 plus x. So it's x minus 1 plus, well, what's 1 over 1 plus x? It's 1 minus x plus x squared minus x cubed plus x to the fourth. And then we cancel, cancel. We find ourselves with exactly the same answer we had before.